Hello, my name is Robert Attrell, and I am a program officer at NSERC with the Discovery Grants Program. This presentation will include information relevant to completing a Canadian Common CV for the NOI stage of the Discovery Grants application. The CCV allows researchers to maintain their CV data in a centralized Canadian repository. The system is important in the Canadian research funding application process and is required by a number of funding organizations in Canada. This includes the Social Sciences and Humanities Research Council, or SHRC, the Canadian Institutes for Health Research, or CIHR, and the Canadian Foundation for Innovation, or CFI. Applicants must attach their CCV to their NOI using the NSERC Researcher CCV template instead of the generic template. We invite you to consult and follow instructions available on NSERC's website. You can find them at the link on this slide. In this demonstration, we will answer the following questions. What are the mandatory fields? Where do I enter information, like journal articles or presentations? How do I submit the CCV in order to attach it to the application in the portal? And how do I obtain consent from HQP? At the top of this slide, you will find the link to the CCV platform, or you can choose to search the keyword Canadian Common CV in your search engine. This link can also be found on NSERC's website. Once you are on the main page, you will find the login button on the top right-hand corner of the webpage. If you have already created an account, do not create another. If you have forgotten your login information, use the forget my username / password functions. You will be asked your security questions, and then revised login information will be emailed to you. If you are a new user, click on the register button. Use your primary email address. This email address will become your username, and it should be the same as your username for NSERC's research portal. Once you are logged in, from the top menu select CV and then funding. You will then select NSERC as the funding source from the drop-down menu and NSERC Researcher as the CV type. Then click Load. You are now ready to add and edit entries in the NSERC CCV. I will now proceed to the live demonstration portion for entering CCV information. Just above the window of sections you need to complete, you will find a link to a PDF document, Specific Instructions from NSERC. This document contains the detailed instructions from NSERC's website. It is strongly recommended to consult this document. In addition, you will find in this PDF under General Information who to contact if you need help with the CCV. A link to the CCV help manual is also included and should be consulted before you start. The very first time you load this CCV, you will see a list of sections or fields that must be completed in order to submit your CCV. In the CCV on the screen, you will notice a series of red X's and green checkmarks beside the list of fields. It is important to understand that there are mandatory fields to complete. Any mandatory field will first appear as incomplete and identified with a red X. The non-mandatory fields will already appear to be complete and identified with a green checkmark even when no entry is indicated. Please be aware that you can add information to non-mandatory fields. If there is information pertinent to your application in this type of field, you should always include it. Each time you add information to any of the fields, click Done. This will save your entry and bring you back to the list of sections landing page. Your personal information can be accessed or edited through the account button situated in the top menu. This is where you will enter your personal information, such as birth date, email address, and password information. Moving along, I'd like to go back to the list of sections and provide some specific information about the location of the CV information. You will notice some sections have a question mark. When you click on this, a help text box will appear and define what is required in this section. Click the pencil icon to complete or edit any of the sections. I will now review the key sections. Personal information section. This section contains 5 fields to identify yourself. Education section. This is a mandatory field where you add your degrees, including postdoctoral degrees. Recognitions. This section is not mandatory, but highly recommended. Describe the prizes and awards made to you, not to your trainees, over the last 6 years. Explain the importance of the awards to better inform certain reviewers that may not be as familiar with them. How to add bilingual text. It is possible to update your CCV in French and in English at the same time. There is a function that allows this in some sections. The Show Bilingual Field button appears at the left hand of the side of the Done button. If you click on it, you will see text boxes for French and English that can be inputted at the same time, thus enabling 2 versions of your CCV to be updated at the same time. We are asking applicants to submit their CCV in the same language as their application. This is to facilitate the reviewer assignment process. Please enter bilingual text wherever appropriate, as it will facilitate the download of the CCV in either official language. The language of the NSERC CCV that is generated corresponds to the language of the CCV webpage used by the applicant. Ensure that the language displayed on the CCV webpage is in English if you intend to submit an English language application, and vice versa. User profile. This mandatory field allows you to enter research specialization keywords. Enter keywords that best describe your area of expertise. Employment. This section is mandatory. It includes academic and non-academic work experience, leaves of absence, and their impact on research. Please include your responsibilities if you are or were an adjunct professor. When explaining your leaves, as much as possible, objectively describe the time frame and impact on research productivity. Research funding history. This section is not mandatory, but highly recommended. List all sources of support, including NSERC grants and university startup funds, received and/or applied for. You can update this information at the full application stage. It helps with demonstrating areas of research, as well as excellence. Activities. This section includes many fields: supervisory activities or supervision of highly qualified personnel, or HQP, administrative activities, advisory activities, assessment and review activities, knowledge and technology translation activities, and international collaboration activities. In the supervisory activities field, please do not use the term academic advisor for your HQP. Only formal supervision and co-supervision should be listed in this section. Applicants must have prior consent from HQP in order to name or specifically identify them in your CCV. Memberships. You should include your participation in committee and other memberships over the last 6 years. Please do not include activities as part of thesis committees. Contributions. This is a mandatory section and includes many types of contributions. Include your contributions to research over the last 6 years that are relevant to the application you are submitting to NSERC. I would like to draw your attention to the presentations and journal articles sections. As you can see, these are two different and separate sections. Please enter your different contributions accordingly. When your students publish with you, please be sure to put an asterisk beside each student's name. This is very helpful to evaluation group members. There is also an option to select or deselect publications from being included in the CCV. Students who have signed the consent form should be indicated with an asterisk in the CCV. For students who did not sign the consent form, only general information can be provided in the CCV and past contributions to the training of HQP. Finally, to list your publications, there is a tool to import publications directly into the CCV platform. Click List and drop down menu options. From the top menu, select Utilities and then Import Publication from Web or File, and follow the prompts. This will add your publication list to your CCV and will populate in the specific related templates. Once you are satisfied that you've completed your CV and the list of sections is complete, that means all are indicated with green check marks, please hit Submit to validate your CCV. If there are any errors with the information you have entered, or if any mandatory fields are incomplete, a message in red will appear informing you that your CCV has errors and to revise entries marked with a red X. It is important to preview your CCV before submitting. By clicking the preview button, your CCV will be generated in a PDF format. You can save your CCV at this point. Upon successful validation of your CCV, the page will refresh and a confirmation number will be displayed. This number is important and needs to be attached to complete your NOI through the Research Portal. This step is explained in slides 30 to 34 of the Research Portal video. Please refer to those slides. Before we end this presentation, let us share a few reminders. The deadline to submit your NOI is August 1st, unless informed otherwise. If you are a first-time user of the system, we encourage you to start early. Completing the CCV can take a significant amount of time, especially if you've never done it before. We remind you that the system is programmed to accept only information from the past 6 years. This could explain a reason for error messages when trying to save and/or validate your CCV. Lastly, please do your best to not duplicate information within the CCV. This ends our presentation, and you are now ready to attach your completed CCV to your Discovery Grants NOI via the Research Portal. Thanks for watching.